Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the channel and welcome back to the video. Now, before we get started, I'd just like to say that this is not going to be a positive video. I know that a ton of the stuff that I do is all positive, but this is not going to be positive. It's not going to be, like, ridiculously, you know, scarring. It's just not going to be super positive. There will be another big video that I'm working on regarding Ryan Blaney. That'll come out tomorrow. I'm not going to give any spoilers about that, but make sure you stick around and check that out. So you're going to need to be subscribed and turn post notifications on so you don't miss that. Make sure you like the video and let me know down in the comments your personal thoughts on the issue that I'm going to discuss today. So let's just get started here with something that may sound good, but is a huge issue, and that will become apparently clear why when I kind of, you know, discuss and go over what's the problem here. So I'm recording this on Monday night, and 704 Games announced that a patch would come out on Tuesday morning, which apparently one of the things that I'm going to say in these patch notes, I'm going to read the entire patch notes. One of the things is that they added a Sunoco scheme for Bubba Wallace, which I should just point out before we get into this that I selected to race as that scheme in this race, and then it just brought me to this one, so I... What? Why? That's... Why? Why? You can't even... Why? But anyway, sorry. So I'll read you the patch notes here, and then we'll get into why this is a problem. They added Dylan Hart Jr. to Xfinity, Bubba Wallace Sunoco scheme, 2020 revised schedule to championship mode, which was supposed to be here on launch, two new custom paint schemes, three custom fonts, more logos and custom car and custom driver, new challenges, Team Penske NASCAR Heat Pro League driver schemes. They fixed an issue with Tony Stewart's scheme. They updated career so that DLC cash will work, trophies that had outdated logos, adjusted DNF parameters. That's a big one because DNFs in career were basically broken. They updated custom championship to allow any tracks in any series. That's awesome. Updated restart zone art at New Hampshire. Updated track art at the Roval. Updated victory scene background at Chicagoland. Fixed various text issues throughout online challenges, options, and driver names. Fixed mismatching online custom car numbers, updated Kyle Busch's Xfinity pit equipment, updated certain NASCAR Heat Pro League driver photos, updated track or dirt track tag art to Fanatec Fairgrounds, updated driver's paint schemes, that's a good one, updated incorrect truck series team descriptions, updated logos in dirt career, updated driver scheme select categories. They removed Motorious and Speed Digital logos, replaced them with 704 Games logos and spectator tickers, which has some ongoing problems. So they just vaulted that for now. So that is, some of those are good, some of those are great, some of those are okay, it's just whatever, but regardless of what you think about some of those fixes, that is a lot of things, and that is a problem. It's good that they're fixing their game, but a game shouldn't need to be fixed, and I think as a gaming community, we have all just accepted that games are released unfinished, which is terrible. That's the dumbest thing ever. Why is that a thing? That should not be a thing. It never was a thing until they started releasing games digitally and got the ability to patch things. And I would almost argue that the ability to patch things has made games worse. I mean, because you can basically just release an unfinished game, which is what we're seeing here. There is absolutely no reason that 704 Games needed to release their game right now. They could have waited until September. They could have waited until the beginning of August. There are so many problems with what's going on here. The one praise that I have left for 704 Games is that they're not as bad as EA. And by that, I mean they don't build their entire game around the fact that it's just a money grab. Ultimate Team. But I'm sure the people at 704 Games are nice people, and I do have respect for them, and I'm gracious that they make us a NASCAR game every year. That's awesome. That's huge right there. Like, I feel like people, you know, take stuff for granted and like to complain a ton when, you know, things don't go exactly right, but these people are still making a NASCAR game for us, and I think that's great that we have a yearly NASCAR game installment that we can play. However, I do think they deserve some constructive criticism. At this point in the video, I'd like to draw a comparison. So we're going to be transitioning a little bit into talking about a different game, and then I'm going to connect the two games. And it might seem a little abrupt at the beginning, but you'll see where I'm going. Now, unfortunately, I don't have any Star Wars Battlefront 2 gameplay because my disc is broken and I'm looking to get a new disc because I love Battlefront 2. But Star Wars Battlefront 2, specifically the 2017 version, not the 2005 version, is a heavily praised game, which is kind of crazy because it started as the absolute just scapegoat of all of gaming. If you had any problem, you could basically connect it to Battlefront 2. And over time, they built that game into probably the greatest Star Wars game of all time, to the point where fans are clamoring for a Battlefront 3 because they stopped live service on Battlefront 2. And there are many, similarities, I would say, between NASCAR Heat 5 and Battlefront 2. Like, for example, I think that the gameplay is the biggest, the core gameplay is the biggest drawing point of both games. The core gameplay in Battlefront 2 is phenomenal, and the core gameplay in NASCAR Heat 5 is really good. I will give it that. But I actually want to make a negative comparison, right? So Battlefront 2 is praised for its epic turnaround, and that is probably deserved. However, I think that Battlefront 2, what should be focused on more, is that EA released a game in that horrendous state. Like, it was terrible. The game was horribly broken, filled with microtransactions, which is another huge problem with gaming. NASCAR E5 doesn't have any microtransactions as of now, besides the season pass, which is phenomenal. The fact that a game can have an option to pay $30 for additional content and is considered basically microtransaction free is insane, by the way. But they released a terrible, terrible game, and yeah, it got fixed, which it should. If I go to the store and pay $60 for a game, or $50 in the case of NASCAR E5, it should work. I am playing a game. Like, if I wanted to get a game that might work, I'd go to GameStop and buy a used copy of NHL 12 for $2.50, like $2.50. And then if it didn't work, it would be a little bit more reasonable. But this is not how it's going. I'm buying a full price game for like a new game. It's not working because the disc is old or the disc is broken. It's not working because the company did not fix the game, and that is a problem. Like, it boggles my mind that they can release a game in such an unfinished state and sell it to people for $50. And then, you know, like, what? Really? That's crazy. Take some pride in your craftsmanship. I don't know. That's just my opinion. I think that it's genuinely almost pathetic, the way that things are in the gaming industry right now. So I just want to take you quickly, before I end this video here, through a list of all of the current major sports titles that I can think of, right? And surprisingly, NASCAR Heat 5 is one of the best. So obviously, I would say the top sports game, maybe not. One of the best sports games would have to be F1 2020. That's the best racing game by far on the market. I would say probably the best sports game as well. That one, not a ton to complain about. I know people like to complain because it's not super realistic, but I think it's still by far the best sports game on the market. Then we have NASCAR Heat 5, completely unfinished. Still one of the better. Now we get into a territory I like to call EA. So Madden, completely broken, revolves entirely around catering to universe mode to make money off of a casino for small children. FIFA, exact same thing, except for Europeans. Sorry, that was kind of, you know, but that was a joke. Then UFC 3, they tried it with, they tried to market UFC as Ultimate Team. How does that even work? It doesn't. It doesn't, which is why in UFC 4, they're taking it out. Huge step forward, but also they're going to charge you for cosmetics in UFC 4. So still riddled with microtransactions. Let me think. What are some other EA titles? I can't think of any off the top of my head. I'm sure there are definitely more, but MLB The Show, literally just Diamond Dynasty. It's the same thing, except a little bit less microtransaction-y. Not much, but a tiny bit less, I would say. But it's literally Ultimate Team, not marketed as Ultimate Team. And then we get to, you know, what I would like to call the bottom of the barrel. And I know a lot of people think EA is the bottom of the barrel. It is not. 2K. And 2K gets a pass because it's fundamentally a solid game. It's not broken. Who would have thought? Every single other EA game is broken. But NBA 2K is not broken. Congrats, you get a gold medal. But it is filled with microtransactions. Let me tell you, it's basically pay to win completely. You can either play about two seasons of, you know, NBA seasons, 82 games, by the way, and, you know, get a good rating, which would take forever, and I don't think a lot of people would like to do that. Or you could waltz upstairs, grab your mom's credit card, and spend money to buy whatever the heck you want. Just terrible. They also have Ultimate Team mode, but it's not really catered around that because they also have another way to bring in massive revenue, which is My Player, which is what I was just talking about. But they also have Ultimate Team branded as My Team. It blows my mind the problems with current gaming that companies can get away with this. This is so corrupt. It's so wrong. It's ridiculously anti-consumer, and it's terrible business practices. And yeah, so that is my thoughts on why NASCAR Heat 5 exemplifies everything that is wrong with sports games currently. And so let me know down in the comments what your thoughts are. I'm sorry that it took a pretty somber video today. But I hope you guys enjoyed. As always, stay safe, have a blessed day, God be with you, and I will catch you guys next time.